of prisms. I can find the volume of a rectangular and triangular prism. I want you to review your formulas for shapes, the area formulas. Make sure you know each of these. Stop the video now and write each one down. A rectangle. The formula is just base times height. All parallelograms are base times height. So that would also mean a rhombus is base times height. Triangle is half a rectangle, so it's 1/2 base times height. A trapezoid is a half of a parallelogram. And then remember, we have to take base 1, so one of the bases, add it to the other base, and then we times it by its height. A kite, you take the diagonal, one of the diagonals, you times it by the other diagonal, and you divide that whole thing by 2. Now, some of you had to learn a circle and some of you didn't. For those of you who did the circle, it's pi times radius squared. These are formulas that you need to have memorized. So any of them that you didn't know, you need to start studying. So volume, what is volume? Volume basically is this inside. It's filling up the shape. Should have really started at the bottom, and it's filling it up. So volume is measured in cubes because we want to take the length and the height and the width. So we have the length here, its height here, and the width going back this way. So volume can be written as any of these: length times width times height, length times width times height, width times length times height, and so on and so forth. These are all the same because the commutative property says I can multiply in any order. So let's get these definitions in. You can choose either one. Volume is the capacity inside a shape, or it's the amount a shape can hold. In a rectangular prism, it's length times width times height. Let's do an example. So here are some. Let's do this one. So you take your length times your width times your height. So you take 6.5 times your 6 times 5, and you will get 195 yards to the third power because we're going cube now. How many cubes can fit in there? And you have a third dimension. Plus it's yards times yards times yards, so that's yards to the third power. You go ahead and try this one. Stop the video now and give it a try. Did you get 1,320 centimeters cubed? So what if you are finding the volume of a triangular prism? Well, a triangular prism is just really half of a rectangle. It's just half of it. So you're doing the same idea. Is half of a triangular prism is half of a rectangular prism. So you're taking your length times width times height, and you're dividing it by 2. So let's look at an example. So in this case, I could take 4 times 15 times 7 and then divide that whole thing by 2 because I have length times width times height. And remember, a triangular prism is half of a rectangle, so it's divided by 2. So I could take 4 times 5 times 7 and divide that all by 2. And you would get 210 feet cubed. So I want you to try this one. This 6 is considered its width. Stop the video now and give it a try. Did you get 295.2 centimeters squared? What about these kind of prisms? Now, sixth grade standard says you only have to do rectangular and triangular, but I just want you to look at these. If that's the case, we'd have to know different formulas for every single one. But here's the cool thing about prisms, is you can use this formula for all prisms. Because this capital B now really just means the area of the base. Area of the base. So if we go back here for a second and let's look at one of these. Here's the base, which is 6.5 times 5. If we find the area of that, and then we're going to fill this up, it's times 5. So it's the same thing as length times width times height. If you look at the triangle ones, here's, remember the base is what it has two of. So in this case, it's this and this over here. So it's 4 times 7. Divide that by 2 and then times 15, which gives you the exact same answer. So they're the same. So in the case like these other kinds, we would have to find the area of this space, which would be a trapezoid. So we use the area for the trapezoid formula, then we times it by 7. So you have a worksheet that says the riddle is what is big and gray and lives in California.